Good morning. Happy Friday. We'll give a minute for everyone to log in this morning. This cool, crisp morning. Good morning. Hey, everybody. Welcome. Happy Friday. You did it. Another week in the books. And heading into the weekend. I'm excited to be here with you guys this morning. Hey. And we're going to have a fun, energetic flow to kick off the weekend. Good morning, Kelly. Hopefully, you know, the days are kind of blending all together into sometimes not knowing what day it is. So trying to have some little bit of schedule and normalcy, good morning Kathy, can be helpful. And just even celebrating these little milestones like Friday. So let's get to our mats, and we're gonna start this morning with one of my favorite ways to start class is twisting. So you're gonna come to the top of your mat, and just have like a pretty, about shoulders width distance apart with your feet. And then that way you can just have really firm stance into the mat. And then just go ahead and start to just kind of twist, swinging your arms side to side and all of your body right and left. And then just start to firm up through your legs so you feel yourself pressing into your mat. And then that'll help you start to feel your core, your belly, start to get a little fire in it too. And then bring your hands to your shoulders and twist. So now you're pressing in your feet a little bit more because you're gonna start to go a little bit faster. So again, that full rotation, feeling your spine warming up. Just feel good to move. And then take your arms up towards the ceiling. A little bit of like tilt upward in your chest. Almost like a feeling of backwards a little bit. And just start to go as fast as you can, just building this heat. Again, squeezing through your legs, staying supported. And then just bring your hands back to your shoulders. Keep going as fast as you can with that twist. And then remember, keep squeezing through belly button towards your spine so you feel your low back supported. And then start to bring your hands down by your sides. And then we'll start to slow down again. And then just come to center, just pause, close your eyes, and just feel all that energy moving through, all that breath, moving through your body. And we're gonna keep that moving into our flow. So go ahead, inhale, sweep your arms up. On your exhale, lean over to your right, and you can interlace your palms or interlace your fingers. And then take another inhale, come up through center, and exhale, just lean over to the left. This is called a half moon pose. It's another half moon. So you wanna make this shape of like a curved moon. Keep pulling up through your belly. And then inhale, look up, go back, and exhale, fold forward. Halfway lift, breathe in. Step back to your high plank. So we'll just take this first one slow. Take an inhale, and then lower either halfway down or all the way to your belly. Exhale, and then then up dog or cobra. Inhale. Downward facing dog. Exhale. Take a deep breath in here. And then press your heels back to empty the air out. We're going to take another inhale and a long exhale. And then one more. Inhale, exhale. Lift your heels up high. Bend your knees and look forward. In this first one, step your right leg forward and then your left leg forward. Half lift, breathe in. So that flat back. Exhale, fold down. Gaze comes up towards your navel. Rise all the way up, maybe a back bend. Exhale, dive down. We're going to move a little bit faster today. Half lift, inhale. Step or jump back, chaturanga. Upward facing. So spill your head back there. Downward facing, move from your core. And then three breaths in and out. Really root through your hands and see how much strength you can grip from your mat. And then on the next inhale, lift your heels high. Bend your knees. This time, left foot steps forward. Just feel how that feels different. Half lift, inhale. Fold down. Remember, gaze up towards your navel to get the stretch in the back of your head. Rise up. Look up. Fall down. Half lift, inhale. Step or jump back to your chaturanga. Exhale. Upward facing, downward facing. Remember, keep pressing into your thumbs as you press back. And then three more breaths here and really start to open the backs of your legs. We'll take that one more deep breath. And on your next inhale, lift both your heels. Bend your knees. This one you can step or hop your way forward. Half lift. Fold down. Rise up. Fold down. Halfway. Step or jump back to your chaturanga. Upward facing. And downward facing dog. Take another inhale. Exhale. Keep moving through the backs of your legs and lifting your ribs up towards your hips. We're just going to take that one more breath. Hopefully starting to feel a little bit of heat. Breathe out. Then lift both your heels again. Bend and look forward. Step or hop. Halfway. Bow down. Rise up. Inhale. Chair pose. Exhale. Land here in your chair. And just pause. So any arm variation you want to take, but consider the most traditional arm variation serves a purpose. So while we're wanting to create some change, when we're a little bit uncomfortable, just consider there may be a purpose to just sitting with things the way that they are. We're just going to take one more deep breath in and then fold to breathe out all the way down tight. Half lift, inhale. Step or jump your way back. Chaturanga. Upward facing. So feel that stretch in the top of your feet. Downward facing. Lift your right leg up high. open. So today, if you want, just go ahead and let that right shoulder come on up and open. So hopefully, you've learned that there's really no wrong or right way to do things. There's more about, like, the intention behind it. And then from there, stay or flip your dog. So you can drop your right foot down. Bring both feet parallel to each other and just launch your heart up and open. Just ready for the weekend. See your heart facing that relief. And then come back up and over. 3-point inhale there. Take your right knee to your nose as you exhale. Step through, warrior one. Rise up. And interlace your hands behind your back today. So go ahead and start to pull your knuckles down towards your thigh, the back of your thigh. And then start to lift your chest up. And then we worked on this a little bit earlier this week, so see if you can do these three things. Just engage through your belly, so nose pulling out in your back, and then lunge deep into your front leg and ground through your back foot. Just those three things. And take one more big breath. Ground into your feet as you breathe out. This time, reach up on your inhale. Maybe go back. Chaturanga. Option to keep your right leg lifted as you flow. And then up dog, stretch through the tops of your feet. Downward facing dog. Take your left leg up, inhale there. Stack and peel your hips open. And then again, just if you want, that left shoulder can just open up. Just let it feel good. Still trying to keep your right leg pressing back though. And then stay right there or flip your dog. Feeling those deep, ujjayi breaths in and out through the nose. And then one more breath, all the way back up and over. Left leg lifts high. Bring your knee to your nose. Step through, warrior one, rise up. And then interlace your hands behind your back. Just got this huge wave of really missing you guys. Missing being together. Do what we learn in our practice, and that's breathe through and find gratitude for just this moment. And also just welcoming the feeling. If you didn't already, bring your other thumb on top as you press your knuckles down for this one. And we'll go ahead, lunge deep and press into the back foot as you squeeze through your core. Lift up, look up. Exhale, then sweep your arms up, still squeezing into your belly. Back bend. Chaturanga. Left foot can stay lifted. Upward facing. Downward facing dog. So we'll flow again. Right leg lifts. Inhale. Warrior one feet. Rise up. Take that bind. Exhale. Then inhale, lift up. Exhale, breathe out. Sweep your arms up. Maybe that back bend, but squeeze through your belly, supported. Lift up, chaturanga. Down through your flow. Press into your thumbs, big time. Downward facing dog. Makes it harder to press back. Left leg, inhale. Step through, warrior one. But harder usually just means more integrated. It means you're gonna be stronger. Exhale, hands behind your back. Inhale, lift your heart. Exhale, sink into your feet. Squeeze your bandhas, your belly, your pelvic floor, and then reach up, in breath. Back bend, chaturanga. All the way down through your flow. Downward facing dog. All right, 5 breaths here just to catch your breath before we move on to our next warm up flow. Maybe a little pedaling out of your feet. Maybe a little stillness, channeling and holding your energy in. All right, lift both heels high. Bend your knees, so press into your hands. Look forward first, and then jump forward. Halfway. Fold down. You can even grab around the backs of your legs. Chair pose. Inhale. Forward fold. Exhale. Half lift. Inhale. Plant your hands. Lift your heels. Chaturanga. Upward facing. Downward facing. Right leg lifts. Inhale. Step through, warrior one. Rise up strong and low, and then open to warrior two. Settle into this pose. See if you can feel your temperature of your body shifting. Just feeling these more subtle layers. Helps create our awareness. Inhale, reverse, lean back. We're going to stay here for a breath. Exhale. So you'll feel this in your side body, just ribs reaching back, down through your flow. Chaturanga. Upward facing. Pull back, downward facing dog. Lift your left leg high. Warrior one. Inhale. Warrior two. So what we welcome passes through us. What we resist, we hold on to. Let's just welcome right here today and let it just move through us with grace. With breath. Now lean back, reverse. Stay for the exhale. A little bit more in that lean. Down through your flow, meet in downward facing dog. Warrior one, warrior two, stay low, reach back, stay for the exhale. One more to get into that side body, down to down dog, however you want to flow there. Left leg, inhale, warrior feet, warrior two, reach back, we're going to pause, exhale, inhale, chaturanga, up dog, down dog. All right, y'all, one more time to pause for those five breaths. So you can stay in your down dog, you can go to your child's pose. And then another deep inhale. Let that air go out. Take your right leg up, breathe in. We're gonna go right knee to your right elbow. Exhale here. So if you want, you can take the arm balance. Just bend into your right arm, straighten your front leg, and lift the back foot. Otherwise, just hold right knee to right arm. Five, four, three, two, one. Right leg goes up and back, inhale. Step forward, crescent lunge, rise up. Four breaths here. Remember, squeeze into your belly, lunge into your front knee, press into your back foot. Another inhale, hands together to your heart, twist right. Keep a breath in there and a breath out. You've got one more breath here, and then on your exhale, split your arms open. Left arm comes down, right arm goes up. So one day, your left fingertips might touch the floor. But for now, we're just gonna reach, 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 making a straight line of fingertips to fingertips. And then another breath in, you can do this. Another breath out, one more inhale, and then you're gonna unwind and skandhasana, low lunge to the back of your mat, side lunge, exhale. Take your left hand down, right arm up. Inhale. Stay for this exhale. You can pull your toes towards you. One more deep breath in. Deep breath out. Warrior two on your inhale. Reverse. And side angle. Right arm goes down, left arm goes up. And then just take these few breaths here to just guide yourself deeper into the pose. So if that looks like a half bind for you, take the half bind. If that looks like the whole bind, take the whole bind. And then everybody unwind, side angle, inhale here, back down to your skandhasana, exhale, inhale, warrior two, hold there, exhale, reach back, down to side plank. So bring your left hand down and take your right arm up. So if you want, you can grab your toes as you go. You can drop your left knee down. Hold for five.
Shake for four. Breathe for three. Two. One. We're just going to place that right foot back down and drop into a low lunge. So drop your back knee down. And then just bring your hands inside for a lizard. Good. Just one more breath here, y'all, not too long. Empty that air out. Step your right foot back. High plank. We're going to hold here for three breaths. So breathe in, breathe out, in, and out. And then just one more deep breath in. Lower all the way to your belly as you exhale. Come into your cobra. Inhale. Stay there. Exhale. Stay lifted up high with your ribs lifting. And then come into your locust pose. Breathe and squeeze all the muscles in your back like you're going to press them up to the ceiling. Start to feel everything lift higher. And then that biggest lift you can do, inhale there. Exhale, hands on your shoulders, forehead to mat. Cobra or up dog, inhale. Downward facing dog, exhale. Nice job, y'all. So lift both your heels up high, bend your knees and look forward, step or hop, half lift, bow down, chair pose, inhale, hands to heart, twist right, exhale. We're gonna flow a little bit, so inhale back to center, exhale, twist left. Inhale, center. Exhale, twist. Inhale. Exhale. Two more. Inhale. Exhale. Inhale. Exhale. Back to center. Breathe in. Twist to the right. Hold it here. You can open your arms out wide if you like on this side. For five, sink your hips down low towards your heels. Four, three, two, one. Come back to center. We're gonna drop down into camel. So you lift your heels and lower your knees. Arms are gonna stay lifted for this camel version today. Reach up, look up. Start to lean back, but hips are going forward. Hold. Breathe. And come out slow, slow, slow. Hips come back to your heels, chair pose. Take that full breath that opens you up. And then dive down, exhale. Half lift, breath in, flat back. Step or jump, chaturanga. Upward facing, downward facing. Pause here for a few breaths. Just remembering to just feel and give it all you've got. Welcome it, welcome the challenge, let it move through you, let nothing get stuck. The way you can tell if things get stuck is you're playing them on repeat in your head. The way you can let them go is just tell yourself, ask for it to move through. All right, y'all. So take your left leg up high. Inhale here. Left knee to left arm. Hold here. We'll take your arm balance for your chaturanga arms for five, four, three, Gentle focus. One more breath, y'all. Twist to your left. For four more breaths, stay with the twist. And then option to open your arms, just five more breaths. You can do this. Doing a little extra challenge. Gaze comes up to your thumb. And then one more breath in. Skandasana to the back of your mat. Right arm comes down, left arm comes up. Your left foot can stay down for support or bring your toes up for a little bit more challenge and hold. And then just that one more big breath in here. Back to warrior two. Let's inhale, reverse. Exhale, side angle. Left hand comes down, right arm goes up. And then remember your options to take your half binds, your full binds. All right, y'all, come all the way back up and over to Skandasana. Exhale there, and then back to warrior two. Inhale and land on your exhale. Reverse, lean back, down through our flow, chaturanga. Oops, I'm sorry. We're going to side angle, side plank. So right hand comes down, left leg goes up. Wobble and shake and build strength and play and smile for 3, 2, 1. Now chaturanga, upward facing, downward facing. Take that left leg up and we'll step it through to the lizard. Just drop your back knee down. And see if you can really just let your right hip fall here. So we're really working into stretching out the hip flexor. Starting to get into your psoas. All these muscles that really get short the longer we sit. And the more we round in our posture. Another breath in. Just go back to your high plank. Hold here, breathe in. Stay for the breath out. We're going to do four more breaths now. Inhale, exhale. Hold plank. When the going gets tough, you realize you are tough. For two, and then the last breath in, lower all the way to your belly, nice and slow. Cobra brings you up, inhale, and then locust or floor bow. So you can grab onto your ankles or go right back to your locust, kick up, lift up, and give it all you got. Got another big, big lift. Open, open, open. And then exhale, lower down. Everything lowers, hands underneath your shoulders. Launch up into cobra or up dog. And press back, downward facing dog. Good, y'all. And then those 5 breaths just to resume like a end a cycle. Lift both your heels up high. Bend your knees, so press into your hands. Look forward and leap forward. Halfway. Fold down. Chair pose, so just go right into it, nice and low. Exhale, twist to your left. Inhale, come back up through center. Over to the right. Back through center. To the left. Stay low, in through center. Avoid that lifting and lowering. Inhale. So over to the left, hold here. Stay for 5, maybe open your arms out wide. 4, 3, sink low, 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 low as you can go. 2, 1, back to inhale to center. Exhale, fold down. Awesome, y'all. And then just rise all the way up. Stretch up. We're gonna go into eagle. Right arm comes under, right leg comes over. Just one more breath here. And then unwind and reach up. So just let that breath flood into your chest. And go to the other side. Eagle, left arm under, left leg over. Good, y'all. And then unwind. Come all the way up. Inhale here. Lift your right knee and grab onto your knee or your toe for big toe pose. Find the crown of your head lifting tall. And then open up out to the side. And then come back to center on your inhale. So see if you, when you let go of your toes, you can keep your heel as high as it is. Hold for 5, arms up to the ceiling. 4, 3, 2, 1, we're gonna shoot it back. Warrior 3, so hands are forward, if possible. You can always bring your hands to your heart if you need to, but if you can, hands forward, elbows up by your ears, lift your back heel, high as your glute, and hold for 5, 4, you can do it, stretch as long as you can. 3, engage your belly to pull even farther apart. 2, 1, standing splits. Just lift and let your head drop. Let that be a release. And then you can stay here. You can play with your hops of your handstands. You can bring your left hand around the back of your left leg. And maybe your right. And then just take that little bit bigger lift up, way up high, way up high. And then feet together, fold. Good, y'all. Chair pose. Inhale. Stay there. Exhale. Launch up, spring up, inhale. Big toe, grab onto your left leg. And then open to the side. to center so you can keep your heel just that same height when you let go. Breathe in. Breathe out. I know it's tough. You can do it. In breath. Out breath. Lift it up. Stay for the exhale. And then one more. Reach high, reach high. Shoot back. Warrior three. You've got this, y'all. Stretch long. So remember, squeeze your belly button up towards your spine, and that'll help you squeeze your glutes. Standing splits, hands to the mat, whatever version of play. We're working on a checklist, like a sticker chart for my daughter, and we had all the subjects for her school, we had chores, we had box, and then we remembered we needed to put play on there. Make sure that we were scheduling time for play. To remember, what is all this for if we're not having fun? Alright, one more. Big breath, lift up high. Feet together, fold. Right into chair pose on your inhale. And then you're just going to split your knees apart so we can come into crow. So knees up onto your arms. I'm going to walk you through this. So if you know crow, you just go. If you're doing crow for the first time, come with me. You're going to just pick up, rest your knees under your arms. You're just going to pick up one foot. Yeah? And then you lower that foot. And you pick up the other foot. And then you lower that foot. And then maybe you look forward and you pick up both feet. And if you get it for a second, amazing. If you get it for no seconds and you just squeeze in, amazing. Hold, y'all, for five. You've got this. Push the mat away. Four, three, two, one. Step or jump back. Chaturanga. Up dog. Inhale. Down dog. Exhale. Take a breath in. And a breath out. All right. So one more inhale there. Let it go out. We're going to lift up onto your heels, bend your knees, and just step or jump all the way through to your butt. We're going to pause in our boat pose. All right, so lift into your sit bones. So if you feel like you're down here, come on up with me. Come on forward. When we're going to play today, you're going to grab onto your big toes. And lengthen forward. So it's like you want to make a V shape. Right? And then what you're going to do is you're going to rock up and back. So rock back and up. Try to catch yourself. We're going to do that five times. So four more. Rock back and up. Keep going. Good. Hopefully that lightened the seriousness up and took your mind off of your core work. So we're going to hold here. Keep holding, lifting. And then lower down to your low boat. And then lift up to your high boat. Hold here with your hands heart center, twist to the right. Come back to center on your inhale, lower, exhale, low boat. And then inhale, come back up. Hands to heart center, twist left on your exhale. Inhale here, and then lower. Come back up, twist to the right. Center, lower. Up, twist, up, lower. Just one more time, each side, up. Twist, up, lower, up, twist, up, lower. Good, hold here, five, butts right up into the bridge. So wherever you're feeling this stretch, just embrace that feeling, welcome it. That is the areas where we're feeling a little bit of tension, of tightness, of holding patterns. So remember, welcome and let it through. And then just take two more breaths. Inhale, you might be able to see your breath here. Exhale. One more, inhale. And lower everything down. So we'll just reset a little bit with the windshield wiper. Back to center. We've got a bridge or a wheel. You take whatever you like, go for it, lift up. We'll meet there and we'll hold here for five, magic number five, breaths, four. Keep pressing down and lift up, three, two, and then lift a little bit higher on that last breath in and lower down slow. Hug your knees into your chest. Those rock and rolls we did before, we're going to rock up and back all the way through to your belly this time. We're going to take our arms out wide to a T so you can see your hand in the same line as your shoulder. And then roll onto your left side. The hand stays exactly where it is. Right knee can come up to the ceiling like a kickstand. Your right hand can stay on the mat or it can come behind you. See if you can breathe ease into your body. Let go of the walls to it, more just receive it. And then come over to the other side. So flatten that right arm out first. And then come back through center. You're just gonna press up into your Sphinx pose and reach around for your back foot. So you're gonna lean into your left hand and grab onto your foot. And you're just gonna pull your heel towards your glute. So you gotta keep pressing into your left hand so you're not slumping down. And then if you want, you can flip your grip, fingertips forward. It's not necessary, but just keep squeezing your heel towards your glute. And then turn your chest forward and breathe for five. And release. You can windshield wiper here if you like for a minute. I like to feel massage across the tops of my legs into the mat. And then we'll go to the other side. So go ahead and get your right arm for support. and squeeze. Turn your left shoulder forward. And release. Awesome. So just go ahead and from here, press back into a child's pose. Knees are as wide as the mat, maybe even a little bit wider. And I want you to just really feel your low back just release and soften. And roll up into your cat back. And drop your belly into your cow. And then back to your downward facing dog. You're just going to bring your thumbs together to touch. Take your right leg up on your inhale. And bring your right foot to your pinky for that lizard pose. Go ahead and drop your back knee down. Inhale your heart forward, and exhale, let your knee fall open. So we did a little bit of prep work for this when we were laying on our belly, stretching through your quad. So hopefully you feel a little more open. You can reach back and grab onto your foot. That same sensation, squeezing your heel to your butt, turning your elbow up to the ceiling. Shift your hips back into a half splits, or if you want, you can go into your full splits. So if you're at home and you have some blankets under, you can support yourself under your right thigh if you feel like a little bit of distance between your thigh and your mat. It's going to be more helpful than pressing into your arms. Into half pigeon. So right foot starts to come across. Allow yourself while you're breathing to let your breath remove tension every exhale. Gently and slowly peel your way up, maybe a little bit of a back bend here, come out of this. Back to your downward facing dog. You can pedal or take your legs up. And then just left leg into the lizard pose. which is going to turn into what's called dragon. So you let your left knee fall out, pull your back foot towards you. Hear your quads saying thank you. They're telling you so loudly, thank you. And then shift back into your half or full splits. Splits right into your half pigeon. Let this descending feeling be like a letting go. Couple more deep breaths here. And then go right down onto your back for Savasana. Bring your feet just about as wide as your mat. Let your palms rest open. For your Savasana today, I want you to just imagine your body releasing tension with your breath. So whether you breathe consciously or unconsciously, you're always breathing. As you exhale, count back from 10. Every exhale, this feeling of letting go a little bit more, of letting tension go a little bit more, layer upon layer. Leave you in your Savasana to come out whenever you like. Miss you all, and we will see you again sooner than we think. Namaste. Have a great day.